We started our robotics team about 12 years ago to really try to give students something to focus their engineering interests on.
It's just like any other game. You have strategy, you have defense, offense, you know, and you have another teammate that you work with too, so there's two bots on the field.
Because you can always like build a robot or something in your own time, but it's just more cooler and awesome to compete against other people, right?
When you're driving, it's so in the moment that it's like, whoa.
All points are achieved through getting cubes in your goal zone.
So once we have a stack of however many, we could move the ramp up.
And so we came up with a linear rail system that would angle and pivot and move a linear rail. There's an autonomous round and there's a driver control round. Autonomous round is autonomous. You program the robot. If you can do well in autonomous, your chances of winning a match are really high.
I think driving is more pressure, especially when you're at the competition and everybody's yelling and screaming and talking.
Over the years, I think our biggest achievement is we won the World Championship back in 2009.
And we actually were able to qualify for the World Championship.
Our team just won the regionals at CSUN. We've qualified for the World Championship. The team is getting ready to go to World. They're working on their programming. They're working on their driver skills. They're going to be ready.
I mean, hopefully we do really well. We've been trying really hard.
Have consistently scored in the top in the world, qualifying for World every year.
We put in a lot of work during class time, during our free time, and during our breaks.
And I think that's one thing that sets our team apart is they practice relentlessly.
I've been here every day. This past week, I've been trying to do all programming.
And this year, we're not going to be satisfied with being in the top 10. We're going to be number one.
Yeah, it makes us feel good because we plan so much of it ahead of time.
Yeah, same way.
So, and so it feels rewarding that work we put in during the winter break paid off.
Gotta have that drive to learn something in order to be successful.
Our community college students are competing against master's and PhD students constantly. There are many students that do this as their master's thesis project. And again, that makes it a really high level of competition. So it's just something we're doing for a long time. We do it really well.
Other kind of competitions, you have a lot of rules, strict kind of guidelines. Whereas robotics, if you have an idea, you could kind of build it.
It's just like you get a kit of Legos and then you want something to do to work with those Legos, but Legos doesn't sell it. You make it yourself.
One of the things we found is that robotics keeps people passionate about schooling. Engineering school can be tough, and having something to keep you going and apply what you're learning in the classroom is an amazing way to stay focused on your studies.
I'm able to apply like my C++ skills that I've learned in class in order to make the robot run.
Learn new things such as 3D printing or CADing, and also learn how to program gyros and sensors and all that.
Robotics is great because it combines mechanical, electrical, and programming.
I like that we could have an idea and then just do it.
The number one thing that we learned here is how to be able to cooperate and work with each other.
I like my team because I feel like we have a very nice communication with each other. We're able to get things done.
Most of our students are aiming to transfer. It's not all engineering students, but our students are aiming to transfer. They transfer to top institutions, continue to stay involved there. A lot of them will end up working in the robotics industry. We have a tremendous amount of robotics industry in the LA Basin, and you'll find our students at JPL, you'll find them at every aerospace company. They're working on drones, they're working on really any part of high tech. You're gonna see Mount SAC students involved in, not just being involved in those teams, but in some cases leading those teams.